The relationship between your bike cadence and your cadence running off the bike is a subject that's been debated for years in triathlon.
Yeah, it's commonly said that your bike cadence needs to match your running cadence so that your muscles are primed and ready to run straight off the bike.
Well, it has been proven that running with a slightly higher cadence is more efficient. So should we be cycling with a cadence in line with that? Well, the issue is some people prefer to cycle with a lower cadence, but is that then impacting their runoff?
Well, that's why we're here at Team Bath and we're going to be using the help of head physiologist Jonathon Robinson to help us shed some light on this. Now, I'm afraid to say, Mark, we're going to be the guinea pigs.
Okay, whilst Heather is getting set up behind me, let's run through what we're going to be doing today. And given that there's only two of us with a relatively limited amount of time, we're going to be condensing experiments into very short but intense brick sessions, going straight from a 10-minute bike to a 5-minute run off. And Heather's going to be doing that at her half Ironman intensity, whilst I'm going to be doing it at my sprint distance intensity. And we're going to be doing 3 experiments each. And we're going to hold our normal run cadence of around 170 steps per minute throughout all the tests, but we're going to change our bike cadence. We're going to do one test with our bike cadence quite low, around 65 RPM. We're going to do one where we match our run cadence, so around 85 RPM. And then finally, we'll do one with a high cadence on the bike, around 105 RPM. So we really do cover both ends of the spectrum. And to make things fair, we're going to do them in completely different orders. Heather is going to start with a high cadence and I'm going to start with a low cadence. And you may be wondering what we're going to be recording for our analysis. And well, to be honest, given that there haven't really been any solid scientific findings on this subject, we're just going to record everything from VO2, heart rate, perceived effort of exertion, and even lactate. And perhaps one or more of those will help us draw our own conclusions.
Well, Jonathon has very kindly put the results together for us and done a bit of analysis, but there's so much for us to look at, we decided it was best to come back here to the studio where we can take our time and have a look properly.
Yeah, and obviously there were only two of us and we crammed a heck of a lot into a short space of time. So this is hardly the most accurate experiment, but it will be interesting to see what it shows. But before we look at any data, let's talk about how it felt. So how did you find the different bike cadences?
Well, obviously I had the slightly easier test anyway, and doing half Ironman pace for just 10 minutes, none of it felt that hard. I did start with a high cadence, which was a bit of a shock to the system on the bike, but it did mean when I went to the run that running at that pace on the treadmill, it felt fairly comfortable. As for the 85 RPM, it all felt fairly comfortable. But interestingly, the lower cadence on the bike actually felt the easiest. But then when it came to the run, it did feel a little bit sluggish to get going. Mixed feelings, what about yours?
Yeah, well, obviously I started with the low cadence and the obvious part was when I ran off. I just felt like I was stomping the treadmill. I really struggled to find the rhythm on the run. And then on the 85 RPM, to be honest, that's probably my preferred cadence anyway. So I just felt really at home and really comfortable on that. And then with the high cadence, admittedly, I was probably pretty tired by then. So I think it just all felt quite hard. My RPE was higher on both the bike and the run, but it will be interesting to see what the data show. So
yeah,
should we take
a look? Well, starting off, we're just going to look at the data from the cycling. And interestingly, I had a lower VO2 score for the lower cadence.
Yeah, likewise. I actually had a lower VO2 with the low cadence, and then my highest VO2 was with the highest cadence. And then the matching cadence sat somewhere between the two.
Yeah, and I think I was pretty similar to that as well.
Yeah, and that's funny. So basically, our bodies are running more efficiently when we're riding at a lower cadence. And perhaps we are just better trained at the lower cadence. That's our preferred riding style.
Yeah. But anyway, we wanted to find out how the changing cadence affected our run. So let's have a look at those results. Well, there you can see my VO2 started low on the run after the low cadence, but then quite quickly it started to go up dramatically. And when I did the high cadence, it was the completely opposite way around.
Yeah, mine did exactly the same. And maybe it's because we're working our muscles harder on the bike with the low cadence. So it eventually just catches up with us, which is a bit like what you said. Perhaps if we extended the bike length out, we would have seen it on the bike. And other than a slight increase in my VO2 with the low cadence when I got onto the run, my other VO2 scores were pretty close. So it does all really come down to your personal preference.
Yeah, and I can actually get some of my results to support that, because 85 RPM is my personal preference, as is yours, Mark. And on the run from that, my heart rate was lowest, my perceived effort was lowest, and my lactate. Even though for my distance it was very small margins, it was still noticeable.
Yeah, and one other thing I noticed was, having done the low cadence first, was just how much fatigue I felt in my muscles. It's almost like I've been in the gym doing squats or deadlifts. So I definitely know I won't be choosing the low cadence for my racing. Well, as expected, we don't really have a definitive answer, but what was really interesting was just how efficient the low cadence appeared to be, and then it all switched and turned out to be the less efficient, especially when we got later on into the run. It just really kicked up.
Yeah, well, that brings us back to the 85 RPM, and maybe we're a little biased because that's what we cycle at and then run at, but I think it does match that theory that if you're cycling at the same cadence, it is then naturally easier to run at that cadence when you get off the bike.
So I guess our recommendation would be to test it yourself, and an ideal opportunity to do that in is a brick session. You can do different cadences and then run off. And if you like this video, give it a thumb up like. And to see more videos like this, just click on the globe to subscribe to GTN.
And whilst we're on the topic, if you want to watch a video on running cadence, just click here.
And we have a great little video on draft legal triathlon, comparing clip-on bars versus on the drops. And you can see that by clicking here.